Hey everyone, Mitch from AbelCine here looking at LED lights. And you know, when people think of LED lights for our industry, they really think about small little fixtures that can sometimes be camera mounted or tucked in a corner, get a little sort of effect of light somewhere. And that's a great use for them, but they don't think about really bright fixtures, really high output, high efficiency lights. And it's just not true anymore for LED lighting. Now you can get really powerful, bright lights that are LED based. So let's look at the Nila line of lights. This is the Boxer, and you can see it is an array of LEDs that each one has a lens on the front to control the beam, to direct it, to get great efficiency out of it. Now the Boxer is a 200 watt light, and it is the equivalent to an 800 watt HMI in brightness efficiency. So you can see it's a very bright light, and that is a 1/4 power amount. There's a great savings in efficiency. I can just plug this into any outlet, no problem. It's a narrow beam of light that comes out of it just as is. So they also have these lens plates, and it's a holographic lens. It's a piece of plastic, if you will, that's been etched to not diffusion, mind you, but it sort of directs the beam of light, so you can expand that beam. You can have from as low as 10 degree up to an 80 degree beam, so you can really control that. You just slide it in there. Now I've expanded that angle that it projects, and if I wanted to, I can diffuse it. I can bounce it off whatever thing. I can even put a Chimera light softbank on it. The mounts are directly built into the light, so you don't have to put like a speed ring on to mount it up. It's not the same as an HMI that would have, say, a PAR or a Fresnel lens on it for that sort of control. But what do we mostly use these kind of light fixtures for? We're bouncing into ceilings or punching through diffusion or blasting through a window. The control that we're doing, well, maybe we put a Chimera on it to get a soft directional light. For that type of use, this is a great efficiency. Both in power and getting light output. And honestly, it's about half the price of those types of units, of the equivalent HMIs. So you're really talking about a pretty smart fixture. Now this is a daylight balanced light, and the ones I all have here today are all daylight balanced, but they also make them in tungsten. So if you wanted to have that sort of use and tungsten balanced light, you could have that as well. This is the Boxer. If I took four of these and put them together, you would get this light. This is the Nila SL, or I guess a super large, if you will. And when I switch this on, you'll see it's quite bright. 500 watts gives you the equivalent of a 2.5K HMI. So this is really bright, bright, blowing out the video camera here, light. There's no real heat coming out of this. I can barely feel any kind of warmth. And you can see all this finning and just, you know, how solid in general this is made. The heat management is a big concern for Nila. So they really control that very, very well in the design of these fixtures. No UV, no IR issues. The lights can be fully dimmed, and they have a dimmer control right on the back, as well as having input-output for DMX so that you can connect it to a dimmer board or whatever kind of controller and be able to control it that way. You can see that when I dim and bright control, I have a great range that I can adjust the light, and there's no flicker. Shooting at high speed, if I'm at full power, zero flicker at any frame rate. If I dim the light, unlike a lot of other LED type fixtures, or a lot of other fixtures in general, I will not get any flicker with any of the Nila lights up to at least 1500 frames a second. Tested to 1500 frames a second with our Phantom cameras, no problem with any flicker at any frame rate up to 1500 frames a second, no matter whether you're dimmed or not. Really strong light. Now the lenses are available for this, just like they are for the smaller fixture. And there's even a skirt so you can hang it overhead and have a general room light sort of effect. If a light fixture like this is beyond the scale of the kind of fixture that you might need or be interested in, then there's this guy. If the SL is the equivalent of four Boxers, and if I cut a Boxer in half, I would have the Varsa. So this light is the equivalent of a 400 watt HMI, yet it only uses 75 watts of power. It's their newest light, it's their most efficient light. So you can see I'm running it off of this little battery right here. This is Anton Bauer brick. They have an Anton Bauer plate as well as the option for a V-mount plate, so you can go either way. And it's just a 4-pin XLR that plugs right into the back so that I could run it off a battery belt or something if I wanted to, up to 18 volt power regulation. And it can take AC power as well. Same dimmer control, same DMX input output, same lack of flicker or in the light. You can put the lenses in here as well, and it has the mounting points for taking a Chimera softbox right onto the front of this unit. So that now you have, look at this, it's a really efficient little package to work with. And again, it's about half the price of the equivalent HMI light. So now we're talking about a great savings, great efficiency there. 75 watts, I can run this light off this little battery here for about an hour and a half. I can get a bigger one and run for almost 3 hours with the available batteries in this this mount. I also am using LED lighting. So I as opposed to an HMI bulb that will last me a few hundred hours, I get 20,000 hours plus out of these before I would ever have to worry about the emitters on this thing. This is the Nila Varsa, this is the Nila Boxer, and this is the Nila SL. These are all daylight units, but they're also available in tungsten from AbelCine.